In this video, we're going to explore the star system known as Algol. Algol is a bright star located in the constellation of Perseus, and it's been nicknamed the Demon Star in certain parts of history because of its changing brightness. Welcome to Learn the Sky. My name is Janine, creator of this channel, and if you're new here, be sure to click the subscribe button as we journey through the sky together. Perseus is an ancient constellation that can be seen in the autumn season in the northern hemisphere. It can be a fairly easy constellation to point out if you know where to look. I use the Pleiades star cluster and Cassiopeia to help me find Perseus. Perseus has a collection of bright stars and unique star clusters, and the two brightest stars, Nirphak and Algol, stand out in the night sky. So in this video, we're going to explore Algol, which is often nicknamed the Demon Star. It's an excellent example of a variable star since its brightness can change throughout the night. Let's take a closer look at the brighter stars of Perseus. Here we have the official star map released by the International Astronomical Union, and you can see the shape of Perseus highlighted here and black. The two brightest stars are here. This is the alpha star of the constellation Nirphak, and then we have Algol. And notice how Algol is designated as a variable star because it has a dot with a circle around it. And that indicates that its brightness changes over the course of time throughout the night. Let's take a quick look at the alpha star of Perseus, known as Nirphak. This is a blue star that's estimated to be 510 light years away, and its name is derived from the Arabic term meaning elbow. It is a circumpolar star when viewed from the mid-northern latitudes, and in fact, it's the brightest star in the Alpha Persei cluster, which is an open cluster that you can see with the naked eye if you have dark enough skies to view it. Another interesting thing I found is that in Native Hawaiian astronomy, its name is Hinalii, which is in some Hawaiian folklore, Hinalii is the point of separation between the earth and the sky that happened during the creation of the Milky Way. I love learning about different star names and histories from different cultures, so I was happy to find something about Native Hawaiian history. The Alpha Persei cluster is one that I use to help me find Perseus in the sky. But now let's dig into Algol. Algol is often nicknamed the Demon Star, and it's estimated to be between 90 to 93 light years away. It's actually a triple star system in which there is a blue giant star, an orange star, and then another small bluish white star that's going around these two. And we're going to take a look at a simulation of what that looks like. Its name comes from the Arabic term demon head, but as I was researching more about this star, I found out that Algol has a lot of different names associated depending upon the place and culture and the time. And often it is depicted as a head or a severed head. So just that goes to show you how there's always like connections between the histories of these stars. But this is the best known example of an eclipsing binary star system. And if we were to zoom in and take a look at what Algol looks like, which Algol really is the beta star of the constellation, it is a three star system. So we have an orange star, a blue giant star, and then another smaller star circling these two. So what happens here is as these stars go around each other, when one of the stars eclipses another, then the brightness of it changes. So we're going to take a look at what that looks like. Here in this simulation, I'm using a program called 100,000 Stars, which is a Google Chrome experiment. And if you want to learn more about how to use this simulation, go see that video. But here it's showing you the Algol star system, which is an eclipsing binary. So what happens is when one star, as these two are going around each other, as one star goes behind the other star, the brightness of it dims from our perspective. But when the stars stars are next to each other, the brightness increases because of the combined light from each of those stars. But this is not just a binary system, but if we go ahead and zoom out, this simulation does show the other triple star that's here, the third star in this system. It's farther out, it's smaller, but it's going around the two main stars. So if we were to zoom out, there you can still see that small star, but the combined light of these two. And if we were to zoom in even further, there, those are the two eclipsing binary stars that we observe the difference in the brightness as they circle around each other. Let's review how to find Perseus. In this photo, there are a collection of constellations. So when looking for Perseus, I usually look for Cassiopeia. She can be used to direct you towards Perseus. If you happen to have a really dark sky, try to look for some of the star clusters in Perseus, such as the Alpha Persei cluster and the Double Double cluster. If we were to point out where everything is here, here is where Cassiopeia is, and you can use Cassiopeia to point out the Andromeda galaxy as well, and the Andromeda constellation. If you want to learn more about that topic, go see those videos. But then Cassiopeia can also be used to point towards Perseus. However, Cassiopeia is not the only way to find Perseus in the sky. You can also use the Pleiades star cluster, which you can see right here, and also the bright star of Capella to help you find Perseus. So if we were to point out where Perseus is, you can see the brightest star is right here, that's Mirfak, and then right here is Algol, and this is the star system we're going to take a closer look at. But the things you really want to use to help you find Perseus are Cassiopeia, Capella, and the Pleiades star cluster. If you want some more practice with finding Perseus and learning a little bit more about its mythology, go see that video. If we analyze Algol from a historical perspective, in many cultures it was connected with stories of demons, spirits, or monsters. In Greek mythology, Algol is often represented as the head of Medusa. She had snakes for hair, and if she looked at you, you turned to stone. In Hebrew folklore, Algol was called Satan's head, and the name Algol itself is derived from the Arabic term Razagul, which means head of the ogre. But remember, the stories of the stars vary depending upon the place, time, and culture. But by learning the history of the stars and their ancient stories, that can help us remember how to find them. We've come to the end of our video about Algol, the second brightest star in the constellation of Perseus. Remember that Perseus is a constellation that can be seen during the autumn season in the northern hemisphere, and the best way to find it is to use the Pleiades star cluster. You can also use Cassiopeia and the bright star Capella as well. When looking for Perseus, you want to look for some of the star clusters that are located in this particular constellation. Algol is the second brightest star of this constellation, and it's a great example of a variable star because its brightness changes over the course of the night. However, Algol is not the brightest star of this constellation. That designation goes to this star called Mirfak, and it's part of the Alpha Persei star cluster that's also located in Perseus. I wish you luck finding this star. It's one that has always fascinated me because of its variable brightness and also the history and culture that's associated with it as well. Remember, it takes time, practice, and patience to view the stars, and I always encourage you to seek out dark skies when trying to view the stars. It will really enhance your perspective, and hopefully you'll get to see more objects as well. Good luck, and keep looking up.